Well, a new study done by Salary.com suggests that if a stay-at-home mom were to get paid for her work, she'd be earning $138,000 a year.
I like this story. Here's the deal. The typical mother puts in a 92-hour work week with 10 different jobs, like housekeeper, cook, driver, teacher, even psychologist. So joining us now with more on this topic is attorney Tom Klein. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Chanel. How are you?
What do you make of this?
Well, these kind of things are actually important to a trial lawyer like myself, because we have to prove these kinds of things in court. Oftentimes there's a death case or an injury case. So this caught my eye and I found it very interesting. Well, go ahead.
Well, I was going to say, Tom, you're speaking about a case typically, which is what this could be wrapped around. In fact, I remember a case a few months ago where a wife suing a husband in a divorce saying she's owed this money even though she didn't physically get a paycheck. How does that play out in a courtroom?
Well, it really amounts to the value of the services. And here, Salary.com, which has been doing this for a number of years, said, look, there's a value to being a housekeeper, a daycare person, a cook, a computer operator, a laundry operator. even there's a formulation in here for CEO, which, by the way, gets $183 an hour compared to a housekeeper that they value at $10 an hour. The thing here is that the Salary.com, and it's just interesting for all of us, obviously, says that there are 92 hours a week that a stay-at-home mom works, of which, therefore, 50 hours roughly would be overtime, 52 hours.
And it's interesting, I'm reading this study here, it says it's a 3% raise from last year when the average house mom, so to speak, should have made $134,000. So, well, you know, with the cost of inflation, or with inflation, I guess.
I think mom deserves a lot more. They actually, if you go on their website, it's a lot of fun. You can actually go there and you can figure out what hours you as a stay-at-home or a working mom works, and then do it, and they'll send you a check. Or you can, for example, for your mom, Chanel, you can send her a check for as a take-home mom. There's another interesting aspect, which I want to just mention briefly, which is the survey also talks about marketable moms. Employers are actually looking for stay-at-home moms because they believe that they're good at multitasking, compassion, dependability, work ethic, relevant life experience, management skills, people skills, all of those things that make someone actually a good worker. It's a lot of fun, and it's interesting, and it's important as well.
I agree with you.
So, yeah, well, it's safe to be on this side of the debate. There's no way in the world you would ever come out and say that you didn't think that. I think they should make $1 million.
it's one of those holy grails that no one's going to argue with. Moms are obviously right. Important. Should they be paid? That's another story. But is there a value to the service? That's the real issue from an economic point of view, either in a dispute or in a courtroom or in the marketplace.
Interesting topic. Attorney Tom Klein, thank you for talking with us.
We can come back on Father's Day. We can do dads.
Right.
Well, we know how much they're worth.
Right.
I'm the guy. We know how much they're worth.
All right. No, I'm just kidding. Thank you, Tom.
My pleasure.
All right, fine. All right, let's check in now with Mike and Julie.